Good morning. This is the day that the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad in it. We're glad to have each and every one of you on this beautiful Sunday morning as we gather together as God's wonderful people to lift up the name of Jesus Christ, that name that's above all names. We gather together as God's wonderful people to reach out to one another as we continue to pray for one another as we make that difference in one another's lives. We gather this morning as God's people to make a difference in the community in which we live. We gather together to carry out that which God has called us to do and what God has called us to be about, to hear the cry of those around about us and to make that difference. We gather together today to worship hymn number 144, This Is My Father's World. This morning, as we go to the Lord in prayer, we want to remember all those folks in Florida, those in along the coast and the coast of South Carolina, and all those that were affected by the storm. We just ask the Lord to walk with each and every one of them in a mighty way. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, as we come before your throne of grace today, Heavenly Father, there are people everywhere that's hurting. There's people that don't know where to turn. They lost everything, Lord. But Lord, we know that you're in charge. And Heavenly Father, we know that you'll see them through. And Lord, Lord, we just ask that you might continue to be with each and every one of them in a mighty way. Heavenly Father, there are people that are hurting in this community. Lord, we ask that you might watch over them, that you might be with them in a mighty way. Heavenly Father, that you might meet their needs. We'll always give you the praise and the glory. Heavenly Father, we thank you that you are concerned about each and every one of your precious children. And Heavenly Father, we thank you for your great, great love that you have towards each and every one of us, that you were willing to give your Son, Jesus Christ, on Calvary's cross, that our sins might be forgiven, that we might be justified in your sight. Heavenly Father, we thank you for such concern and such love. We thank you for that mercy and for that grace that makes it possible for us to have life and to have it abundantly and to have that assurance of eternal life. Heavenly Father, thank you for your Son, Jesus Christ, who gives us that hope for each day, who watches over us and walks with us. Heavenly Father, thank you for that precious Holy Spirit that comes to live and dwell in our hearts, to guide us and direct us in all the ways that you would have us to go. Heavenly Father, may your Spirit move within each and every one of us, that we are drawn closer to you and closer to one another. Heavenly Father, we pray for all those that are sick and those that are shut in, those that's been lifted up. Lord, you know each and every situation. Lord, we ask for your touch to be with each and every one of them. And Heavenly Father, we thank you for these precious lives that are gathered here today. Lord, you know each and every one of our hearts, and Lord, you know what each and every one of us are going through. Lord, we just ask for your touch as you make that difference in each and every one of our lives. Heavenly Father, we thank you for the prayer that Jesus prayed on many occasions. We pray this morning as your children. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come. Thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever. Amen. Hymn number 452, My Faith Looks Up to Thee. Thank you. Psalter reading is found on page 803. We're reading from Psalm 81. Sing aloud to God our strength. Shout for joy to the God of Jacob.
Praise a song, sound the tambourine, the sweet lyre with the harp.
Blow the trumpet at the new moon, at the full moon, on our feast day.
For it is a statute for Israel, and an ordinance of the God of Jacob, who made it a decree in Joseph, when God went out over the land of Egypt.
I heard a voice I did not know.
I relieved your shoulder of the burden. Your hands were free from the basket.
In distress you called, and I delivered you. I answered you in the secret place of thunder, and I tested you at the waters of Meribah.
Hear, O my people, while I admonish you. O Israel, if you will but listen to me.
There shall be no strange god among you. You shall not bow down to a foreign god.
I am the Lord your God, who brought you up out of the land of Egypt. Open wide your mouth, and I will fill it.
By way of announcements, remember Saturday, October the 22nd at 5 p.m., we will have our hot dog supper and hayride here at the church. And so get the word out and let's enjoy the fellowship together. And I still have plenty of mustard and turnips if any of you would like to have them. We have plenty of them, and the rain helps, and so we will have more than we had before the rain, so feel free to get some mustard and turnips if you'd like to have them. Heavenly Father, we thank you for this privilege we have to serve you and to do that which you have called us to do. And Heavenly Father, we thank you for each and every gift that's been given this day. Heavenly Father, we ask that you might bless those gifts, that they might be used to make a difference in the world and the community around about us. Heavenly Father, bless those that continue to give week after week. Bless them 100-fold. For we ask it in Jesus' name. Amen. Would you stand for the doxology?
Yes.
In the 17th chapter of the Gospel of Luke, beginning with verse 5, and the apostles said unto the Lord, increase our faith. And the Lord said, if you have faith as a grain of mustard seed, you might say unto the sycamine tree, be thou plucked up by the roots, and be thou planted in the sea, and it should obey you. But which of you, having a servant, plowing or feeding cattle, will say unto him by and by when he comes from the field, go and sit down to meat, and would not rather say unto him, make ready wherewith I may sup and girt myself and serve me till I have eaten and drunken, and after thou shalt eat and drink? Does he thank that servant because he did the things that were commanded him? I thought not. So likewise, ye, when you shall have done all those things which are commanded, you say, we are unprofitable servants. We have done that which was our duty to do. The word of God for the people of God. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, we thank you for the scripture and the message that you have given unto me this day as I break the bread of life unto your wonderful people. Heavenly Father, may every word that flow from my lips be pleasing unto you. And Heavenly Father, these your precious children who have come today to hear the bread of life, Heavenly Father, may their hearts and meditation thereof be pleasing unto you. Heavenly Father, we ask that you might anoint every word that is proclaimed and every word that is received. For we ask it in Jesus' name. Amen. Our subject today is, Lord, increase our faith. Jesus had told his disciples what they were going to face along the way, that they would go through hard times and difficult times as they would make their way to Jerusalem, and they would find difficulty ahead. And so his disciples said to him, Lord, increase our faith. Today, many of us can identify with those disciples. For we say, Lord, increase our faith. Because we as Christians are being persecuted all around the world. And we never thought that it would come to this great land of ours where Christians would be persecuted. But if you stand up for your children, the government will come after you because they think that they have control over your children. When we as parents know what is best for our children, yet they try to tell us how we should raise them and what they should be able to do. But we set the standard for our children. And when we, as Christians, take a stand against abortion, we have those in Washington that's willing to come after us because we believe in the sanctity of life. We believe that every child is a child of God. We believe that they should have the same freedom that we have. And so it is our responsibility to stand up for every child. And so this morning we could say with those disciples, Lord, increase our faith. Jesus said if you had the faith of a mustard seed, you could say to the sycamine tree, uproot yourself and be cast into the sea, and it should obey you. This morning we ask for that faith. But where is our faith this morning? Where do we look for our faith? Is our faith in who we are? Is our faith in I can do it myself? Or is our faith in someone else? There's only one place for us to put our faith this morning, and that is in Jesus Christ and what he did for us on Calvary's cross. As Jesus Christ came from the portals of glory, he came down to this earth in human form as a baby born in a manger in Bethlehem. Jesus Christ came as the Lamb of God. And Jesus Christ would begin his ministry, and then Jesus Christ would fulfill God's plan. For Jesus Christ would go to the cross at Calvary, and there on the cross of Calvary, he would shed his blood for you and for me, that our sin might be atoned for, that our sin debt might be paid in full, and that because of his shed blood, God could look down upon us and see no sin, and we are justified by the shed blood of Jesus Christ. Jesus Christ there on Calvary's cross made the covenant of grace with God. We now live by grace rather than by the law. And there on Calvary's cross, Jesus Christ gives us the gift of salvation. There on the cross, Jesus Christ gives us the Holy Spirit to come and to live and dwell in our hearts. When we confess that Jesus Christ is the Son of God and that he rose victorious the third day, the Holy Spirit automatically comes to live and dwell in each and every one of our hearts. And that Holy Spirit will take us places that we never thought we would go. That Holy Spirit will guide us and direct us and remind us of who we are. Remind us that we are a child of God. Remind us of what Jesus Christ did for us on Calvary's cross. The Holy Spirit will help us to be more like Jesus. And there on the cross at Calvary, Jesus Christ gave us all the gifts and benefits that we need in order to live a victorious life, to be able to carry out God's will, to be able to make a difference in the world around about us. That's where our faith should be this morning. If our faith is in anything other than Jesus Christ and what he did on Calvary's cross, we are destined for failure. This morning, what do we do with our faith in Jesus Christ? Do we just sit still? When those disciples were filled with the Holy Spirit on the day of Pentecost, they could not stay silent any longer. They went out into the world to proclaim Christ. And everywhere they went, they told what Jesus Christ had done. The one that you have crucified, this is what he has done. Silver and gold have I none, but in the name of Jesus, stand up and walk. You see, he gave them the power, and they put that power into making a difference in the world. The gospel of Jesus Christ went throughout the world because those disciples did not remain. And folks, today we take our faith and we go forth as those that have gone before us. We take that faith into the world and we tell the story of what Jesus Christ has done for each and every one of us. Every one of us here today has a story that we can tell about how Jesus Christ changed our life. What a difference he made. He paid it all at Calvary. And so this morning, we are to take our faith and take it out into the world, that the world will know that we are his disciples because we have love for one another. When we come to the end of our journey of faith, what will we say about our faith? What will we say about what we have done? Jesus said, how many of us have a servant that goes out into the field and he works and he feeds the cattle? And he comes in, and immediately you fix him a meal. No, when the servant comes in, you tell him to go and fix your supper so that you might eat and drink. And then after the servant has done all that he's supposed to do, then he sits down and eat and drink. And so when you and I come to the end of our journey on this earth, we say, along with those disciples, Peter, with the beloved John, with the Apostle Paul, with Mother Teresa, with Martin Luther King, Billy Graham, Dwight Moody, and all those that went up before us. When they came to the end, they said, Lord, I am an unprofitable servant. I have simply done my duty. Apostle Paul says, we are saved by grace and not by works. And so when we come to the end of our line, we do the work of the kingdom because of what Christ Jesus did for us on Calvary's cross. But because he has commanded us to go forth into the world and make that difference, we simply say, Lord, I've done my duty. I've done what you have called me to do. My prayer this morning is that when each and every one of us come to the end of our life, that we too can say, Lord, I'm your servant. I have done my duty. I've done all that I could for your kingdom. this morning, our faith is in Christ Jesus. And as long as we keep our faith in Christ Jesus, the Holy Spirit will continue to be with us. And we can make that difference in the world around about us. Turn to page 12 in your hymnals. Everyone this morning is welcome to the Lord's table. Christ our Lord invites to his table all who love him, who earnestly repent of their sins and seek to live in peace with one another. The bottom of page 13, holy are you and blessed is your Son, Jesus Christ. By the baptism of his suffering, death, and resurrection, you gave birth to your church. Deliver us from slavery to sin and death, and make with us a new covenant by the water and the Spirit. On the night in which he gave himself up for us, he took the bread and he gave thanks to you and he broke the bread, gave it to his disciples and said, take, eat, this is my body which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me. When the supper was over, he took the cup. He gave thanks to you and he gave it to his disciples and said, drink from this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sin. Do this as often as you drink it in remembrance of me. And so in remembrance of these your mighty acts in Jesus Christ, we offer ourselves in praise and thanksgiving as a holy and living sacrifice in union with Christ's offering for us as we proclaim the mystery of faith. Pour out your Holy Spirit on us gathered here and on these gifts of bread and wine. Make them be for us the body and blood of Christ, that we may be for the world the body of Christ redeemed by his blood. By your Spirit, make us one with Christ, one with each other, and one in ministry to all the world until Christ comes in final victory and we feast at his heavenly banquet. Through your Son, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit in your holy church, all honor and glory is yours, Almighty Father, now and forever. Amen. The body of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, take. The blood of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, take and drink. Heavenly Father, these are your precious children. Heavenly Father, increase their faith as they go forth to make a difference in the world around about us. For each and every one of these has a story to tell what you have done for each and every one of them. And when we come to the end of the line, Heavenly Father, may we say, Lord, I've done my duty. I've done your will. Arise, my brothers and sisters, go in the name of Jesus and serve him until the day he comes, until the day he calls. In Jesus' name, amen. Our closing hymn, we have a story to tell to the nations. Hymn number 569, first and last verse. Thank you. Let us pray. Teach us, O Lord, to serve you as you deserve, to give and not to count the cost, to fight and not to heed the wound, to toil and not to seek for rest, to labor and not to ask for any reward, except that of knowing that we do your will through Jesus Christ our Lord. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen.